Hey guys, welcome back to this video series on the Cucumber framework. So today I'm going to talk about background steps and scenario outline, right? So what are these two keywords in Cucumber framework, and how do you use them when you are writing your scripts? Okay, so let's see what is first a background step, right? Okay, so the keyword is actually background. Okay, and sorry. Okay, so what does it mean? When you are writing your feature files, right, and there are multiple scenarios, there will be some steps which are being repeated in every scenario, right? So for example, if you're writing a feature file for Gmail, right, and or any e-commerce site, okay, so there you have different scenarios, like adding your items to your cart, or checking out your items, or searching for some items, right? But for each of the scenarios, you need to always either launch your e-commerce site and then log in into that e-commerce site, right? So that two steps are always common across all these three scenarios, right? So in that case, you need to repeat these two steps in every scenario. Now, in order to kind of reduce your, these are actually inconsequential steps, right? In your scenarios, because these are not part of your scenarios. These are some background things which you need to perform in every scenario. Now you can separate kind of these steps and put it into background steps, right? So background steps, it contains the same keywords like given, when, then, right? So same keywords which you use in your scenarios, you can use the same keywords in background to write your steps, right? So given, when, then. Now it is also written before the scenario, right? And the most important part of background is steps are executed before each scenario, right? So keep in mind, all the steps are executed before each scenario. So if you are not sure that a particular scenario should have that step, don't include that in background, okay? So that's what about background. Now let's see this with an help of an example, right? Okay, so yeah, so I have written another login test, right? So I'm using a Sai application, you can say. I am launching the application. I am entering username and password and clicking on submit button. So this is the login test, and user is displayed homepage. So very simple test, right? Just launch the application, enter username and password, and then click on submit to display the homepage. Okay. Now, since I have a single scenario here, I can have another scenario, right? So where we kind of register the user. Okay, now for that also, I will have the same step. I will have the same step, right? Given launch application. So for my example, as you can see, this is kind of redundant or repetitive test step for every scenario, right? Launching an application. So maybe I can remove this from here, right? And make this as given. So this becomes my scenario. And then before the scenario, I can type background, right? And then here I can put my given statement. Now nothing else changes. You don't need to change anything in login step definitions. the step definitions will remain same. The only thing will change is you are putting this step, you're replacing it from scenario and putting it in background, right? So now when you kind of run this, while running the scenario or feature file, you will not notice any difference. It will still run as it is, but the only difference will be if you have multiple scenarios, this background step will be executed first and then the scenario, right? And background step will always be executed before each scenario. So remember that. So it's a simple test, right? Logging in and then checking out. Okay. So that's what is background. If you have you can add another scenario, and then this step will always be kind of executed before your scenario gets executed. So that's the sequence of execution, right? Okay. So let's now talk about scenario outline. Right. So what it is, scenario outline is pretty similar to scenario, right? It's a keyword. It helps us to execute a scenario multiple times with different sets of data. Right. So if you want to execute a scenario multiple times with different data, right, which is very common in automation, right, we have to test a different sets of data for a particular scenario, right? So in that case, you need to use scenario outline. Now it contains examples section, right, where you define your data. Okay, so there is an example section where you can define all this different sets of data. Now there are different ways of actually running multiple sets of data in a scenario, but scenario outline is one of the ways. Okay, so we'll talk about the other ways in coming videos, but we'll see this in real time, how to use this. Okay, so let's look at the example. Okay, so how can we put this in action here, right? Now if you look at this scenario, log into application and this step definition, right? So if you look at the step definition, you will see I have some static data here, right? So I'm putting the username and password here itself. But in real time, if I want to log in with a different scenario or a different username and password, it's not possible, right? Again, I need to have another scenario with the same steps, but different username and password. So that becomes tedious, right? When you write scenarios with different sets of data, then your scenarios will keep on increasing and it won't be reusable, right? So to avoid that, we can use scenario outline. Okay, so what you need to do, you just need to convert this into scenario outline. Now it will show you an error that example section is missing, right? So you can tell to create the examples sections. Now the example section, it contains, right, headers, okay, column headers, and then it will contain, just like a database table, it will contain headers and then the values. Okay, before that, we need to make this parameterized, right, these two fields which we want to pass different sets of data. So let's make this, so you can do that by the help of these arrow symbols, right? So once you put this as arrow symbols, and what I can do is, let me create this examples again, right? Now this time you will see it will also create the column headers, which is username and password. Okay, And now, like a table, I can pass my values here. Okay. Okay, so I can take the values from here and put it in the examples section. So username will contain the username. And password will contain the password, right? And now here, what we need to do is we need to convert this as this parameterized, right? We need to pass the username and password here. Username and string password. And we need to replace this with the parameters. So here we'll put username and then here we'll put password. Okay. And another thing you need to change is you need to replace this with regular expressions. So like this. And let's also put these notations, which kind of tell you that it is starting with here. So these are also regular expressions. So it tells you that the string is starting from here and it ends here, right? So user enters username and password, which we have put regular expressions. It can be anything which being passed from the feature file, right? So it will take this value from here and it will pass it to this two fields, username and password. Now you can have any number of values in this data table, right? So and the number of values which you have right here, so what I can do is I can have two values here. Right now I don't have two users, so I'll put the same values here, right? And we'll see. So instead of just executing it once, now it will execute twice because it has two rows, right? So let's see. Okay, so this is the first iteration. This test will iterate twice because it has got two lines in the example section, right? Okay, so that's our first iteration. And as you can see, now the example two will be executed. Now, since I have the same login, it will log in with the same username and password, but you can obviously put different username and password to log in with a different user. So this is just for an example, what I'm showing you, but you can use it based on your scenario and your application, right? So as you can see, it is saying two scenarios, eight steps, right? But we have just one scenario, but we are executing it twice. So it has got two scenarios and eight steps. So this is how you write a data-driven test in Cucumber, right? It's very useful and it's very common for any automation, right? Whenever you are automating any application, you have to test with different sets of data. So scenario outline is pretty much you need to use it whenever you are writing any Cucumber tests. Similarly, background steps, right? So that's also very important. You need to have some background steps whenever you are writing scenarios. You don't want to repeat your background steps in every scenario. So it's better to have a background, right? So I hope this video was useful and you understood the concepts of background steps and scenario outline. In the next video, we'll see more some more concepts of the Cucumber framework, how you can improve this further and use some other features of the Cucumber framework, right? So to keep watching similar videos, you can subscribe to my channel and keep watching and sharing the videos, right? See you in the next video. Until then, goodbye.